Hi guys, welcome to another unboxing by the Indian Meeple, and today we are going to unbox Libertalia, Winds of Galecrest. So this is a reprint of the older game by Paolo Mori and artwork by Lamaro Smith. It's a pirate themed game and it has been just published back by Stonemier Games. So I've been waiting quite a while to try this game and finally got my hands on it. So let's see what we have here. So this game, I think this one is more themed towards, families, because the last one, I've seen the videos of the older Libertalia and it is, I think the artwork is more geared towards, real pirate fanatics. In this, all the pirates are animals. So this is the first printing of the game. Let's see what we have here. So first we have the rule book, the basic what all things are there, the loots, the cards. Then it explains the setup before the game, the setup before each voyage. So it's played over four voyages, which are four rounds. There's a two-player mode, which is a bit different. You have the reputation tracker and it explains everything else in the game. And then we have the automa, which is used to play if you have played any of the Stonemaier games. This is for solo gaming, so you can actually play this solo, and depending on how much your wealth is at the end of the game, you can score yourself. Now these are something which I always love in a game. These are those small dials to track how much money you have. This one thing is, this is used for the two-player mode. The cardboard is thick and very nice. These dials always help in a game. It tells you how to assemble the die behind these treasure chests as well. Let's try doing one of them. So this is a treasure chest, and then both of these dials will go behind this and show a number, and based on that, that is the, so currently we have six wealth in this, so we have six wealth in this, and we'll have something to hold these cardboard boxes, and we can turn them to increase the wealth or decrease the wealth. So that is the points at the end of the game. This is a very nice tracker. I always prefer these rather than the other token trackers that are there in the game. These are so these are already printed on the board. These are the different when you take a particular type of loot, you can activate one of these abilities. These are normally printed on the board. They are printed on the board. There is a calm side where you can actually play an easier version, and then it also has a more take that version of the game. But giving out these tokens, you can actually cover up most of those spaces and play kind of like a hybrid game. The money is all good, like Stonemaier normally does. I wish I had the metal version for this also, like in Scythe. But these are nice coins that you can use. These black tokens are, so these are used to cover up spaces. Again, more worker placement, not worker placement, more spots to cover up on the board. We have those. Finally, we have the board. I can show you the board, which has, so this is the stormy side, and like I said, all these loot symbols are actually all printed on the board. All the cards for the players go on top. The loot goes here, reputation goes here, and that's it. And then we have the calm side, which is not the take that side. It's like a family level gaming side. So this is what I would suggest for, playing in the beginning. Like if it's your first game, then you should play the calm side. So that's the board. nice little insert to hold everything in. So this holds the board and then the rule books on top. These are this is a very nice insert to keep all the tokens. The bag is used to keep all the loot. I would have liked having, you know, Libertalia on the bag, but it's a good enough bag. Then we have all the loot tokens here. This plastic is already breaking apart, but we'll try to get that open. Okay, so these are the loot tiles, which is like acrylic or bakelite. Very nice chunky tiles, all of the different colors in the game, the 7 different colors. And this all goes in the bag, the loot bag, and you pick up like 3 for a 3-player game or 4 for a 4-player game, and based on what loot comes out, you put that on the loot spot. So very nice addition to the game. This looks really amazing, all these tiles. These are the reputation markers. So even if you are playing a 2 or 3 or 4 player game, you need to use all of these reputation trackers. Like all of these should go on your reputation track. Very nice chunky pieces for the track, and we have the white one here, which is like a neutral one. So this plays 5 players. So all those colors are for 5 people. Let's see what's there in this cover. Okay, so these are for the dials. So these are the buttons for the dials. It's quite tight. I want to just show how they look like. So these little buttons, you click them with the bottom part, I think, which must be here. So for now I'll just keep them there. This is the bottom part of the tile, and you keep those and you create those small little treasure chest dials in the game. So I'll keep that safe there. And then we have the different decks. So all of these decks, they have a different back. So this is for the blue player, this is for the black player. All of these decks are the same. So there is nothing, like, it's not an asymmetric game. Whatever cards are here will be there in the other packs as well. Although I just want to see if the artwork is same. So I'll open 2 of the packs and just try to compare a few. So this is the beggar, and let me try to get this open. So I can see the beggar, and all of these cards are ranked, and the quality is really great. Like I think this is quite comparable to Red Rising, where the quality of the cards was amazing. So let's see if we have a witch, which is a 15, and the witch artwork is kind of the same, but you can see the flag color is, in this case the flag color is purple, and here the flag color is black. So I'm not going to open all the decks, but I'll just show you one of the decks here. So let's see the artwork. So you can see all of these bandit, all of these are animals. I don't know, is that an elf? The barkeep, I don't know what the barkeep was. But these are all animal-human hybrids. That makes it easier for you to play with the kids in a family environment, rather than the older one where all of these pirates looked very rugged. And I think that's all. And then we have the red cards. Very nice insert. You can keep everything where it's supposed to be. So that's for the purple player. and keep the red players on the other side. And then once you have created the tiles, you can keep them safe over here. The money in the box and the tiles in the bag. So that has been Libertalia, Winds of Galecrest. If you like to see a gameplay video, drop in a comment. Like us, subscribe. Thanks for watching. Indian Meeple. Bye guys.